Oh, Willy Hershey's bar.
There you go, son. Who can take a sunrise, sprinkle it with dew, cover it in chocolate and a miracle or two? The Candyman. Willy Hershey, man. Candyman can, cause he mixes it with love and makes the world taste good. Who can take a sunny day, turn it into gloom? He'll find you and he'll kill you and he'll tear up your precious room, cause he's the Candyman. Willy Hershey, man. Who can take the rainbow, wrap it in a sigh, soak it in the sun and make a strawberry lemon pie? Have a good day, son.
Bye.
Hi, everybody. Hi, Charlie.
Hi, Charlie.
Look what I brought you. Charlie, where did you get that? I'm starting to get sick of smoking crack. We need real food. So I went ahead and went to the store and got some bread for us. Now the rest of this money, I'm gonna give to Lisa. But not this, Grandpa Joe. This is yours. You're gonna buy your tobacco with this. Well, thanks, Charlie. But a piece of bread really does seem like a banquet. So I think I'll give up tobacco. From now on, I'm just gonna snort cocaine. Is it okay to come in, you know what I'm saying?
Yes, sit down.
Mr. Ido, come on, I gotta make the bus here pretty soon. It's gonna leave without me. Last time you had me in here for an hour talking about animal cruelty. Personally, I don't care, but I don't want to miss the bus again.
What do you want, Mr. Idell?
It's come to my attention that you've had one too many detentions, and you need to clean your act up.
Sir, yes, sir.
We're done for right now. Go on. Get out.
Willy Wonka got 5 golden tickets in the Hershey bars.
Let's go find him!
Hi, everybody, and welcome to 6 O'Clock News. As you know, Willy Hershey released 5 golden tickets into the world the other day. And he's given a lifetime supply of chocolate to anyone who finds a golden ticket and he accepts them. Yep. So, as you know, a day ago, Augustus Gloop found the first golden ticket. Congratulations, Augustus. And approximately 2 hours ago, a girl named Violet Beauregard found another gold ticket. So, how many are left? 3. Who will find them? Who knows? But we will be back another day.
I gotta ask you something. Do you think I have a chance of finding one of the 5 golden tickets?
No, I don't. Really.
But I want it more than any of those kids. I mean,
what made you think you're so special?
Well, I know.
But I've been so good. You know.
No, you don't know. You're a retard. You know what I'm saying?
Hi, everybody, and welcome to 6 O'Clock News. Another golden ticket winner. Who is it? Why, it's a girl named Veruca Salt. And we just got informed about a minute and a half ago that she found a second one, or a fourth one also. Yeah. 2 golden tickets. She found 2. And we asked her to give one up. But no, she wants them both. Why? I don't know. But that doesn't matter. It's not like anybody wanted one anyway. Let's go and do some interviews of how the world is taking to trying to find the last golden ticket. As you may know, many, many places are running out of Wonka bars. They are just not producing them fast enough. So we're going to ask some people on the street if they tell us how many Wonka bars they bought today.
I bought 100 boxes of Hershey bars today.
Well, yeah, I was just walking home and I decided to buy another box of Hershey 100 premium chocolate bars to see if I could get lucky with the golden ticket. And no luck so far, but I'm hoping this will be the box that gets me in there. Well, there you have it, and that's all for 6 o'clock news. Are we cut? Yes. Are you serious? She would not give up one of her golden tickets. What an ungrateful little bit.
Can I have a discussion with you?
Sure, sit down at the table and we'll talk.
Okay. I really want to find a golden ticket. Nobody thinks I can find one, and I really want to find it. And everybody and all these bratty kids have been getting one, and I haven't found one yet. And I should have found one by now because I'm, you know, really good and stuff, and nobody believes in me, and, you know.
Charlie, you have a better chance at me going on a killing spree and killing everybody and sticking them in a 3x5-inch jar.
Well, thanks, Mom. You put it into a perspective that I've never thought of. Bye. How much do I owe you for the food?
$7.95, sir.
Thank you.
Do you think I have a chance of finding one of those golden ticks? Here's your guys' food. Thanks, Charlie. Yeah.
What do you want now, Mr. Rydell?
Charlie, I got you in here because you've been going around saying you're going to get one of the golden tickets. I'm going to find a ticket.
Mr. Rydell, why can't you just have faith in me? I mean, I have just as much chance of finding that golden ticket as anyone else does.
Charlie, this is my chance of finding a golden ticket. This, can you see that space between my two fingers? That's your chance of finding a golden ticket.
Fine. Hi, everybody, and the last golden ticket was found. Now, you're probably asking, who is it? Who found the last golden ticket? But we can't really show you. But we can't, like, give an interview with them like we normally would. Like, we got one with Veruca Salt and Augustus Gloop. But we can't get one with this guy. We can only show a photo. So, here it is. This guy, coming up, found the last golden ticket. Show the picture. I'm totally serious right now. He found the last golden ticket. Watch out, little ones. If you want his golden ticket, you're gonna have to pay the price. I mean, I don't know. Just beat it. Just beat it. It doesn't matter who's wrong or right. Just beat it. Well, that's all. And see you later, everyone. The fun is over. Goodbye. Good. Just go. Just go! Why couldn't I find the golden ticket? Everyone, I have amazing news. The last one was a fraud. Darn you, Michael Jackson. Anyway, the last one was a fraud. Everybody run to the candy shop. Get a Hershey bar. Find one. Find it. We gotta find it. Come on, everybody, let's go.